Hi, I'm Steve Jones and I'm going to explain how geothermal energy works. Now, first of all, I have a diagram here of the Earth. You can't see it all, but this is the Earth's crust, which is quite a thin layer, 15 kilometers at the maximum. And then you've got the core, the very center, which is thought to be liquid, but nobody really knows. And this mantle, which is kind of semi-molten rock. It's rock about to melt. So you can imagine that this is very hot. It's a huge source of energy. And at the margin here, just between the mantle and the crust, you're going to have some very hot rock. Now, we're not talking about going very far down into this. At the maximum, 5 or 10 kilometers, the very maximum, and maybe it is only 1 kilometer. It depends where you are on the surface of the Earth and what the geological situation is there. What happens is this hot rock here is continually heated by the mantle. And therefore, if we push cold water down into this area, then the water that comes back up, if we create another well, then whatever comes up should be hot, because this here will be a place where the cold water comes in contact with hot rock. Normally this rock is fractured, and this is done in a very simple way. You drill a very deep hole here, another very deep hole here. You put a charge of dynamite at the bottom of each and you explode it. So the rock just becomes rubble and the water can flow from one to the other. You push the cold water down under pressure and out it comes at this side, heated up. The temperature down here may well be as high as 1,000 Celsius. So this is the way we actually use the water to bring the energy to the surface. The big advantage of this energy, of course, is that because the Earth is such a huge object and there is so much heat within it, and all the time it is creating more heat from nuclear processes within the Earth, plus other things, this will remain as a source of heat for millions and millions of years. It will take a long time for the heat to run out. So this is a very renewable form of energy.